Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for April the 10th of 2021, well, it is titled Zodiacal Night. So what do we see here? Well, here is an image taken of the sky, and we see this just a few days ago and looking out over the Pyrenees in southern France. And what we see is a number of things in the sky, including the constellation of Orion just slightly to the left of center of the image, including seeing the bright star Betelgeuse up towards the middle of the sky portion of the image. And you can see that the bright reddish star there, and down almost directly below it would be the belt of Orion, and then the bright star Rigel. And going down from the belt of Orion, we would see the sword, including the Orion Nebula. So we can see those off to the left, near closer to the horizon, is the bright star Sirius, which is the brightest star in the sky after our own sun. Now, it is called a zodiacal night because we are seeing what we call the zodiacal light stretching up there. Now, arcing across from left to right and then going up towards the top of the image and then back down is our Milky Way galaxy. However, starting in the little bit to the right of center, we can see the zodiacal light stretching up, which is a glow within our solar system and stretches through the constellations of the zodiac, including the constellation of Taurus, which includes two star clusters visible here, the Hyades and the Pleiades, that are visible. So it is a glow caused by dust within our solar system, and that dust will reflect sunlight back and then give us a little bit of a glow in that direction. So along those constellations of the zodiac, which are the ones that the sun will pass through, as well as the moon and the planets. So we note here that the zodiacal light does not pass through Orion, because Orion is not one of the constellations of the zodiac. It is not close enough to the plane of our solar system. However, it does pass very close to other stars there, including through the constellation of Taurus, which is one of the zodiacal constellations. So we can see a number of stars here, including Aldebaran, as I said, in the constellation of Taurus with the Hyades. And we see a glow of three red stars there. The two I've already mentioned are stars. The third one is actually a planet, and that is the planet Mars up above. So we can see that as well in here. And you note that Mars is going through the area around the zodiacal light, because Mars is a part of our solar system. And the objects within our solar system, like the sun and our moon and planets, will pass through the same area that the zodiacal light does. So that's because it is all one part of our solar system, which overall is very flattened. So it just fits one area here. So that was our picture of the day for April the 10th of 2021. It was titled Zodiacal Night. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Black Hole. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.